morning, everyone. I, as the representative of Israel, would like to talk about the tragic events that are happening right now, specifically regarding the invasion of Ukraine, which has managed to attract the attention of the entire world. I think it is necessary for me to speak about our biggest concern and worries that arose as the after effects of that incident, which has not only threatened the sovereignty and security of Ukraine and its people, but has also done a lot of harm to Russia. And as we all know, Israel is the only democratic state that has good relations with both Russia and Ukraine. According to the UN, hundreds of civilians killed, injured, displaced. It was the dire reality of the situation. Also, over 2 million people had been forced to flee their homes. Tens of millions of people remain in the country, but they face potentially mortal danger. This incident will also leave a traumatic effect on the victims for a very long time. For those reasons, Israel have sent 100 tons of Israeli humanitarian equipment for civilians in the combat zones and those who are trying to leave. It contained with purification kits, medical equipment as well as drugs, tents, blankets, sleeping bags, and additional equipment for civilians who are not in their home in the cold winter weather. In other side, Russia also suffered heavy losses because it was bombarded with various economic sanctions, such as a ban from accessing the rainy day fund that supported the funding of the invasion of Ukraine. It has also negatively disrupted supply chains of Ukraine and Russia that have previously been established. The flow of export and import goods is disrupted, which causes an increase in the price of goods. If things calm down in the next few days and are headed to dialogue for peace, Israel will maintain its current approach by being a mediator as requested by Ukrainian president, giving humanitarian support for Ukraine, declarative condemnation of the Russian invasion, and no sanctions. But if the situation continues to escalate, and the invasion getting deeper that will cause the victims and killing mount, Israel will be compelled to join the Western effort to impose sanctions as the further step of the approval of the United Nations resolution demanding that Russia to immediately withdraw its military forces from Ukraine as well as to completely end its invasion in Ukraine. On behalf of all citizens of Israel, I would like to express the hope that this conflict will resolve before the war develops further and the humanitarian consequences will be much worse than we can even imagine. Also, faithfully hoping for a return peace and safety for Ukraine. Again, we are praying for the well-being of the citizens of Ukraine and hope that additional bloodshed will be avoided. Thank you very much. Yerushalayim.